the Hansen brothers and the Subaru guys, I think. The Subaru guys are really quick here. They have tested here. And Backerud got some free laps on the practice.
Yeah, oh, look at that. Look at, I mean, seriously.
You saw it coming.
I mean, gosh, everybody's cheating all this craziness. All right, so here's Timmy Hansen, Ollie Bennett. We are quickly going to it. Let's see who gets the jump. Ollie Bennett, great to see him out there in his Mini, a proven vehicle with Liam Doran kind of building that vehicle up. But Timmy Hansen gets the jump.
I'll tell you, Bennett's looking good here. He always starts well in that car. He's got the rhythm section and jumps well. Going to pitch it in around the outside. Go on, Ollie.
Yep, hold it.
Ooh, look at that. Timmy's swinging wide, going door to door.
So Hansen in the lead from Bennett then. Up into that back berm section where the outside line looks to be the only one which is an option at the minute. Up and over the jump at the back. Ollie's going well. You know, Timmy's a previous world champion. I think it's fair to say that Ollie's not that, you know, he's not at that level of experience. He's doing all right here.
Yeah, no, he's looking good as we see Ollie and Hansen on track here real quick. Katie, you got some updates?
Well, yeah, you know, Timmy Hansen was saying this is definitely not his driving style. He is not used to this 100% dirt thing. It's more like the 70-30. So as he's learning these car, he's also learning the track, and he's also understanding these conditions. I asked him, what should he be doing? He said, well, I don't think you have to use the brake at all. After he saw Tanner Fowler go flying, he said, definitely the brake. Going to be using that brake quite a bit.
Right on. Thank you for the update. Yeah, the all dirt, I mean, outside of that launch, it's 100% dirt. And I like it. I think it's cool. And the side-by-side's great addition. What
never
else?
So, unfortunately, unseen by you guys, Bennett has had a spin right in front of the announcing booth. I think he's coming over the first crest. He backed it in a little bit too hard, and he was parked right on the apex, but there was a yellow flag. He's managed to reverse it out, and Bennett is still going, but he's about a half lap down, so you can see he's plus 25, and we all know the Joker is in the region of 2 to 3 seconds. So, a good start by Ollie, but Timmy's going to take this one easily. He's still got another lap to go. Now, Robert, we should talk about your next matchup. You said
we do.
You said that Subaru are quick here. You know, we know that Travis is pretty good at jumps, and oh, it's Travis Pastrana. How you feeling?
It's fun. I mean, going ahead against Travis is going to be awesome. He's really fast. I need to push it, so it's good to. Good to see your speed. I couldn't really try my speed now because the spotter said slow down like 1,000 times.
Really?
So yeah, it was hard to know your speed, but for sure I need to push if I want to be close to Travis. So it's gonna be good fun.
And you gotta think the entirety of the weekend. Keep the car together. I mean, game day is tomorrow. You know, the bracket battles, it's good, it progresses, but you gotta think winning the actual event.
Yeah, the main goal now was to just win the first bracket. Because I didn't do that in Utah, but now I get 8 cars or something behind me, so that's good. So now I take everything as a bonus and just try to learn. And the real action is tomorrow, and I don't want to be too far behind in the start tomorrow. That's going to be the main key.
That's what I was going to say. You do want to keep it together, but how much of an advantage is it to be further up that grid? I mean, every row counts, doesn't it?
Yeah, of course. It's going to be, I think, 8 cars in one heat.
Yeah.
That's going to be, you want to be.
In the other one.
Yeah.
With only 7.
Yeah. And you want to be as high in that heat as possible. So I don't want to be starting from the back as in Utah. That was
right. Well, as we take a look at it again, this is where it went south for Ollie Bennett. He saved the car from getting more damage, but Ollie Bennett loses to Timmy Hansen. He will advance on, and as Robin Larson joins us up here calling some action as well. Again, the track is looking great. I'm loving it, right, Robin? I mean, I just think it's drying out. It's looking great. And yes, Andreas got some more laps than you. Just relax, bro.
But I can take it. It's cool.
It's transforming really well.
Yeah, for sure. We stayed away from the rain this day, so I think we couldn't ask for more this day. It could have been much, much worse with the rain and could be canceled and everything. So we could do the brackets pretty good right now. So I think the second round bracket's going to be really hard.
Right on. Well, thank you for joining us up here, Robin. We'll let you focus on the race. You know, we'll see how you do against Travis, or you might be partying early with Street Bike Tommy over at the Red Bull bar.